Hello students, good morning. How are you all? Stay safe. Okay, biology 5th chapter, the fundamental unit of life, cell. Already we discussed about it in online class also. We can see that in detail now. Yes, part 1, under that the following subtopics we are going to see: introduction, discovery, unicellular organism, multicellular organism, structural organization of a cell, and osmosis. See this diagram. This diagram shows the microscope. Microscope invented by Leeuwenhoek. With the help of this microscope, they discovered cell. Because a cell is a very minute structure, we can't see with our naked eye. With the help of microscope only we can see. Yes, this is the eyepiece. Suppose we have to keep our eye near this and view the cell. Where we have to keep the cell? The cell should be kept here. This is given objective lens. Okay, this is a stage. Over this we have to keep the slide, then we can see. Then this is a fine adjustment, just like a knob. This is coarse adjustment knob. With the help of these two knobs, we can adjust and see the cells. Okay, yes, with the help of this handle, only we have to hold the microscope. Introduction. Any structure, whether plant or animal, if we see under the microscope, we can find it is made up of many small units called cells. Cells are very small, cannot be seen with our naked eye. Cell is a Latin word for a little room. See, for construction of a house, we need many walls. That each wall is made up of brick, cement, sand, gravel. Okay, each brick is just like a cell. So cell is the smallest structural and functional unit of life. There are two types of cells: prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic, pro refers to primitive or not well developed. Karyo refers to nucleus. So the nucleus is not well developed in those cells. Best example, bacteria, bacterial cell. Eukaryotic is well developed nucleus is found in those cells. Best example, plant cell and animal cell. Okay, discovery. Cell discovered by whom? Robert Hooke in the year 1665. Free living cells in pond water, bacteria. From pond water only they found. By whom? Anton von Leeuwenhoek in the year 1671. Then nucleus discovered by Robert Brown in the year 1831. Protoplasm, nucleus. What is nucleus? Nucleus is present in the center of the cell in animal, towards the periphery, towards one side of the cell wall or cell membrane in plant cell. Nucleus is the controlling center of the cell. Just a principal is controlling the school like that way. Nucleus is controlling the cell. Then protoplasm, it is a jelly-like material found inside the cell membrane. Discovered by whom? Purkinje in the year 1839. Then all cell arises from pre-existing cell, discovered by Rodolphe Virchow. Then cell theory said by whom? Sclidon and Chavon. Okay, all these. What are living organisms made up of? All living organisms are made up of cells. Cells can be easily seen in an onion peel. See, if you will take onion, the outer layer you remove, then you can see pinkish white layer. That layer, if we remove and keep it under the microscope, we can see small cells. Okay, layer of cells we can see. Size and shape of the cell varies according to the function. The shape is different. It may be cuboidal or polygonal or elliptical or small or very large. Here we can see some type of cells. Smallest cell is PPLO, that is pleuropneumonia like organism. It is called mycoplasma. Largest cell is ostrich egg. Then smallest cell in our body is RBC. Longest cell in our body is neuron or nerve cell. Yes, you can see all those in this diagrams. See, first one is smallest cell. Which is the smallest cell? PPLO, pleuropneumonia. Okay, that is only smallest, mycoplasma, otherwise it is called as. Then largest cell is what? Ostrich egg. Okay, then longest cell is what? Our neuron, nerve cell. Then smallest cell is RBC, red blood cell. Yes, unicellular organism. Uni refers to single. So single cell is present in some animals, some organisms, not only in animal, plants also single cell. Okay, there are some organisms which are made up of only single cell, as in amoeba, euglena, bacteria. These organisms are called unicellular organism. See this is amoeba. Here this outer layer, you can see the foldings. That foldings only what? Pseudopodia. See, pseudopodia, that is false feet. P is silent. Okay, with the help of this only it can move. Then this is nucleus. This is the controlling center of the cell. Then this is the food vacuole. Food is present inside this. Here also one food vacuole is shown. Then this is a contractile vacuole. All the waste poured inside this, then it only send it out. Okay, this is amoeba. Then this is euglena. See, it is known as plant animal because the long hair-like structure is called flagellum. With the help of this, it can move. So just like animal, but it has chloroplast also. Here you can see chloroplast is found. So just like a plant, it has chloroplast. Just like animal, it can move. Because of that, it is called a plant animal. The shape is just like a spindle shape, we can say otherwise. Okay, nucleus is present here in the center. Multicellular organism. Many cells are present in an organism. So here, division of labor among themselves. Okay, many cells, but each cell do particular function. When many cells are grouped together in a single organism, then they are called multicellular organism. Example, fungi, plants, animals. You can see in the diagram also plant. Then here many animals are shown. See, tiger, lion, monkey, fish, then snail. All these are multicellular. But many cells, but all cells came from a single cell only. All the cells thus come from pre-existing cell. Structural organization of a cell. All the cells are made up of plasma membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. So this is common in all, whether plant cell or animal cell. In addition to all these, in plant cells, cell wall is present. Plasma membrane is the covering. Above that, cell wall is present in plant cell. In plant cell, in addition to that, chloroplast is also found. Okay. Yes, here you can see the structure of a plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is made up of lipid, protein. Okay, all these shown in this. Plasma membrane or cell membrane or semi-permeable membrane or selectively permeable membrane. Okay, it prevents the movement of some other materials. It is a very thin, elastic, living and selective permeable membrane from outside to inside and inside to outside the cell. Okay, passes through the plasma membrane. It is made up of lipid and protein. It encloses nucleus and cytoplasm. It helps in protection of cellular components. Yes, diffusion. What is diffusion? Some substances like carbon dioxide and oxygen can move across the cell membrane by a process called diffusion. In this case, there is a spontaneous movement of a substance from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration. Okay, so movement of substance like CO2 and O2 takes place through plasma membrane, okay, from high concentration to the region of low concentration. Significance. What is the advantage? Gaseous exchange between the leaves and air takes place. See, for example, all the parts are made up of cells. So cell is found in stem, root, leaf, branch, everywhere. Okay, so inside the plant, the CO2 enter inside the plant when during photosynthesis. Then during respiration, from inside the plant, CO2 comes out. Okay, transport of food through phloem and loss of water takes place by xylem and movement of ions and solutes from one cell to another cell. So transport of food and also water also by with the help of what? Diffusion. Osmosis. Osmosis takes place from a region of high water concentration to a region of low water concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis is a special case of diffusion. See in this diagram, here first case you can see concentrated sugar solution. See the red color part, that is a sugar. So more sugar is present, sugar molecules are present. The blue color shows the water molecule. Okay, so in this beaker there is a membrane. Left side you can see more sugar, right side you can see more water. So the concentration of water is more in right side. It can easily passes through the plasma membrane. Because of that, from right side to left side it passes. The arrow mark shows. See, because of this, in the next diagram, after the osmosis process, gives equation, you can see in the right side, here in the first column, more water molecules and more sugar molecule. In the second column, the water molecules are becoming reduced because from here the water passes to this. Yes, I will show once again this. See here, the red color molecules are more, that is sugar. Here blue color more, that is water. So the water molecule concentration is higher here, so it is in dilute condition. Easily it passes here. Therefore, after this process, osmosis, the result is shown here. Here more water and more sugar, the amount of water is reduced in this, okay? So this is osmosis. So osmosis is nothing but movement of molecules from high water concentration to region of low water concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Significance of osmosis. What is the advantage? Absorption of water by roots and root has. Water moves from one cell to another cell. It controls the amount of water within the cell. It controls various physiological activities, opening and closing of stomata during exchange of gases, then splitting of fruits due to over irrigation when we are pouring water. Because of that, sometimes dehiscence of fruits and seeds for dispersal. All these are advantages of osmosis. Then hypotonic solution. Yes, from this diagram itself you can understand very clearly, this is nothing but the dry grapes. Okay, you soak that in water. Now what was happened to this? Okay, water is transported into the dry raisin, so because of that the shape is swollen. So the entry of water into the dry raisins inside, therefore it is called endosmosis. Clear? So dry raisins, you have to put it in water, then after some time we can see the cells are swollen like this because the water is entering into the dry raisins. This process is known as endosmosis. See, the medium surrounding the cell has higher water concentration than the cell, meaning that the outside solution is very dilute, so the cell will gain water by osmosis, that is called end osmosis. Such a solution is called a hypotonic solution. Here you can see very well, even you can put raisins in payasam. After making, you can see the shape swollen, that is due to end osmosis. Isotonic solution. Here isotonic, from the term itself you can understand, inside and outside the concentration is same, so there will be no movement of molecules across the cell membrane. This is isotonic. Here no overall movement of water, the cell will stay in the same size. Okay, then hypertonic solution, that is from the term itself you can understand, inside the cell more water, outside the cell the water concentration is less. Because of that, from inside the water comes out. For example, if you put any dry raisins or something in salt solution, okay, the outside concentration is more, the molecule concentration is more but water is less, but inside the cell water is more, therefore water from the cell comes out. Okay, that is called exosmosis. That is called what? Exosmosis. Shrinkage takes place. If the medium, here you can see in this diagram. Next one, endocytosis. Endocytosis means, endo means always inside. Okay, amoeba acquires its food through this process only, because the cell membrane is flexible in nature. With the help of pseudopodia, it can engulf the food material from external environment to inside. Here there are two types of endocytosis, that is called phagocytosis and pinocytosis. Phagocytosis means solid food material taken inside. Pinocytosis means fluid material taken inside. See, here in this diagram you can see that very clearly. This is a pseudopodia. Here the food material, solid food material then taken inside. This is phagocytosis. Here the liquid, so it is shown in blue color, it is taken inside. This is pinocytosis. Exocytosis is the process of exudation of secretions or the waste materials out of the cell through plasma membrane. Just before this we saw endocytosis, that is taken inside the cytoplasm. Here from cytoplasm the material gone outside through the plasma membrane. It is opposite to the endocytosis. When the metabolic waste are thrown out of the cell, excretion takes place. That is only shown here. Here see in this diagram also, the waste material is secreted here, that is moving near the cell membrane and exudated, so it comes out then going outside. We can see this. This is exocytosis process. Thank you. We can see the remaining in part 2.